All right, what up, YouTube? Asian Persuasion here. We're at YCS Atlanta here with my boy Slim right here.
You already know, bro.
Doing some technical files. We're here with the top 16 doors. What's your name and what'd you play, bro?
Colby Potts, and I played FTK Pendulum Magician.
FTK ruined my life around 10. My life ended. Yep, ended my career. But this deck is awesome, so let's get into this deck, bro.
So basically, it's a regular Pendulum Magician deck, except we play the Supreme King engine and use it to just like search Engine Fusion.
Yeah.
And pretty much like 90% of the time, you just FTK your opponent. If they have a hand trap, you just win the game. There wasn't a single match where I didn't FTK my opponent at least once. I probably did it 16, 17, 18 times over the course of the tournament.
Yeah, that is nuts.
It's so consistent.
And it's just as good going second, I'll show you why. So first, just the Magicians. Three Purple Poison, three Black Fang, three Harmonizing. These cards are, I mean, these are the best ones going second. This one's really good with Instant Fusion because it played Thousand Eyes, so it can loop Thousand Eyes back. If you Instant Fusion, take a monster, scale Black Fang, have another monster's attack, bring back Thousand Eyes, take it again. So these are just the best ones. I also played three Astrograph. Stargazer, I didn't open this card very much, but I mean, this card's broken. It's the reason the deck is still playable.
That card's
that card is
it's like quick fix with 2,500 attack.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Free summon, man.
I also played three Chronograph, Time Gazer. A lot of the time, Chronograph, you don't even use its effect to summon this out. A lot of the times, if you have Pendulum Call, you use it as your 8 scale. That way, you can use the 13 scale Supreme King effect to swap itself out and put the 13 scale in the scale zone, because your Magicians can't be destroyed under Pendulum Call. So if this is your 8 scale, you can Pendulum Call, then summon out the 13 scale and swap this out for that and summon Darkroom from the extra deck to search
and that is
with the
broken.
And then this card sucks, but you gotta play it.
The Garnet.
That Garnet.
The Garnet from Magician.
The most insane card in the deck, 3 Darkworm.
Yeah, this card is so
this
good.
Card's best starter card, best extender card. If you open this card, you pretty much are guaranteed to be able to FTK your opponent.
Yeah,
it's like monkey board in the scale, and it's always plus one, so it's insane. And then to go with it, I played two of the Supreme King Gate Zero, and one of the Supreme King Gate Infinity. So basically, how you win is you just, if you open any of these, or Foolish or Shrine, which we play a lot of, you get Darkworm and you get either this, or if you already have this in your hand, you can go get this scale.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you don't, what you do, if you just have this, just the access to the Darkworm, you just get this, Pendulum Summon out. When you make Electrum, you send this to your extra deck. So when you Pendulum Summon out, you Pendulum Summon this out from the extra deck, and you still have Darkworm left in your extra deck, so then you use its effect, its monster effect, because it can destroy itself and another face-up card you control, to special summon a Pendulum Dragon from your extra deck. So you leave this in your extra deck, pop your high scale, summon out the Darkroom, and then its other effect is when it's destroyed, it can put itself in the scale zone. So then you have the 0 and the 13 to search as you
That is insane.
And if you're under Pendulum Call, that's why a lot of times you want the Chronograph Sorcerer to be able to do that combo. Played Foolish, 2 Dragon Shrine. Didn't play 3 Dragon Shrine because you open multiples a lot and it's just really dead and there's not another target in the deck for it. But if you see these cards, you're almost guaranteed to win the game. It's like, I don't know if I'd consider playing more because I always open the FTK anyway, so like it was consistent enough.
Yeah.
But I did brick with the extra Dragon Shrine a few times, but it was fine because like I usually just won it.
Drawing those off Electrum sucks.
Yeah, drawing these off Electrum sucks. But drawing
the drawing desires.
This card off Electrum is broken.
The win con right
the win
if you draw this card, you win the game. Like, I never drew this card and didn't win the game. Ever. Like, except maybe in that last round, but I would have been able to search it anyway, where he had the ogre for the end of the FTK. But if you draw this card, you just summon out
literally. This thing. I read that like 3 times to make sure it was doing what it was doing. I was like, oh,
and as long as you can summon, as long as you have access to Instant Fusion and you can put 4 Dark Pendulum Monsters on the field, which is our entire deck, we don't play any non-Dark Pendulum Monsters, then you just can do 8,500 damage.
Yep, 85.
And then because I'm trying to draw Instant Fusion, 3 Desires. Never banished what I needed. Always drew 2 cards. It was insane. Wouldn't cut it. 2 Allure, because we're trying to dig for Instant Fusion and Darkworm and Shrine. At first I was setting this card out, but then I realized, like, if I see Instant Fusion or, like, Desires, I'm usually just winning the game. Mm-hmm. So I just said, screw it, this is better than any of my side deck cards, because this is by far just, like, the most unfair engine in the room, right?
Yeah.
Because you're playing a real deck that also just FTKs your card.
That's
true. You're not, like, getting, it's not like Gem Knight FTK, where, like, you have to go second playing Gem Knight cards.
Yeah, exactly.
So this is great for digging for cards. We played two Duelist Alliance, two Pendulum Call, and one Pendulum Paradox. Mm-hmm. This is basically, we just wanted as many copies of Pendulum Call as we could have without seeing multiples.
Yeah.
And this was our second Duelist Alliance target, which is really good. Anytime you had a sorcerer in hand, Astrograph or Chronograph, you'd be able to use its scale effect to summon out the little guy. And then once you link summon for the Electrum, you'd be able to, like, activate this and just add them both back to your hand.
Oh, yeah.
And that gives you the monsters in hand to summon out, to have the four dark monsters to do the FTK.
Do that. Yeah.
Wow. And the last card we played was Monster Born.
God card.
It was just super sacky. I top decked it against a Boreload, or my opponent had Boreload in the graveyard, and I, like, top decked it, took his Dante, and killed him. Round one. The original idea, though, was to play around Ogre. Like, if they Ogre our Electrum, and we have the FTK combo, and we also have this, we can just bring it back and
continue on.
I think that's a 40 card.
Yeah, and I can't think of anything I would change. Honestly, it was insane. It was by far the most unfair deck in the room.
I felt used in my match. I was so used as a pawn.
And then extra deck, two Electrum. I missed the third. Every kind of game I went second and had to grind, I kind of missed the third.
Mm-hmm.
But going first, I never missed it because you only need two. The second one can guarantee you the FTK. Because one can put Dark Worm in the extra deck, and then the second one can, like, get you Dark Worm to summon to then get the zero.
Yeah.
So two of those, and then Zephyra Metaltron. It's just a better decode Togger, honestly. And it's insane in this deck because, like, you need to Pendulum Summon four Dark Monsters. So three zones. So what you do is you Instant Fusion out for this. When you have Electrum, you can use its effect to burn for 500 if you want. And then you just go straight into this to then Pendulum Summon. And you just need one more monster from your hand.
That's not hard.
That is not hard. Not all dark.
Nope. They're almost all dark.
Played Boreload. I think I made it once to take... I took an opposing Boreload. This just is like scared. Out opposing Boreloads or like Brawl Monsters, because, like, we didn't play, like, Nistr, so we didn't really have other non-targeting removal. And this was just easier to make because we were playing so many different level monsters, like the level 7 scales, that it was just easy. And we weren't playing Luster or anything like that to search with Duelist Alliance, so this was, like, our best way for non-targeting removal.
Yeah.
And then Link Karibo. This is strictly here for your level 1 fusion monsters. Sometimes you need this to do the FTK combo, because when you don't have an extra monster in your hand, so, like, you have the Zephyra with three zones from the extra deck, and you need one more because you need a fourth Dark Pendulum monster, you can make this, and, for example, you can make a second Electromite and then pop it and then add a monster back to your hand so you can summon.
Free.
This card needs
this
to be
unaffected
banned.
By card effects.
He's unaffected by card effects. So you can't pop him because he's unaffected by card effects.
So
this card is easily just needs to be emergency banned or something.
Yeah.
Because
this is the FTK.
Its effect is it burns for its level times 500, and then it gains 500 attack for its level, and it's also unaffected by card effects. So you summon this out with Instant Fusion, and then once it goes to the graveyard, or it can still be on your field, you
start
use your four Dark Pendulum monsters to make two Supreme King Starving Venoms.
Yep,
rip my life.
So you just link this away, make, like, the Zephyr Link monster, and then you just Pendulum Summon, or you just Fusion Summon, Contact Fusion Summon, two of these underneath, and then you just use each effect to copy this in the graveyard.
It's 4K.
And it just burns for 4K. And then going second, it's even more insane because you can just bait out their back row, bait out their interruptions, Instant Fusion out for this. And then if you have any way to just put two Dark Pendulum monsters on the field, you can then link it away for Link Karibo, summon one of these, use its effect to copy, burn for 4,000, and then swing for 6,800, because it has 6,800 attack from this effect, And it's unaffected by card effects, and its own effect gives piercing damage to all your monsters.
Oh.
So, like, against Burning Abyss, I just Insta-Fusioned this out, summoned a Dark Worm, and just normal summoned a Pendulum monster, burned for 4,000, and attacked over Dante for game. I attacked over Hope Harbinger for game. I attacked over a bunch of like 3,000 attack monsters for game.
Nice it's just
monsters. And then once the effect's copied, it doesn't matter if they have a mirror force or like if they, you know what I mean? If they figure out what's about to happen, it's already too late because it's unaffected by card effects.
Yeah.
So this card is just insane. It's wild. And then the last, I also played Thousand Eyes, so this is really good going second as a fusion target because Black Fang revives dark spellcasters every time it's destroyed.
Yep.
So you go Insta-Fusion out for Thousand Eyes, take something, link it away for Link Karibo, then just scale this to have their other monsters attack, destroys itself, float back out Thousand Eyes, take another thing.
Yeah.
So that's just insane too. I did that a lot. The last fusion I played was Vortex. I made it once the entire tournament. Like one time I didn't open the combo.
Yeah.
And if you can make this, you usually just win the game anyway, so it just didn't matter. For Vortex, I also played Auto Eyes Absolute. And then rank 4s, Baguska. I never made this entire tournament. Tornado, I think I made twice. Once to out an Annie spell, and once in like a grind game against Burning Abyss when I was second. And then the two synchros I played were the Regeki guy, I don't know his name, Supreme King Regeki. This is great, it's just board wipe that you can make out of your extra deck. Really good card. And Omega, which I think I made once all tournament. Omega, the reason we played it was because we wanted it to be our out to cherry, so if we got cherried, we just make Omega on the standby phase, put an Electrum back in the graveyard. And then we can tag it out, and then on the next turn, we can summon the fusion and copy Electrum's effect. And you have Omega coming back this with 2,800 attack. And once you resolve Electrum, like, you usually have enough upward for game anyway, so you didn't actually need the fusion zones for it. And the only other benefit to this was if your hand was netty enough, you could make this before you FTK'd them to see what they were playing.
Yeah.
That only came up like once and it's super extra. But the hardest part about this deck was siding because when we'd FTK them, we just had no idea what they were playing.
Yeah,
so if your hand was nutty enough, you just make this first and they would have no idea what's going on, and then you FTK them so you know what to say. That happened like once. The side deck, most of this is actually just not used. Three Wavering Eyes for the mirror. Just sided going second. I never sided going first. Never. I just put the deck back to the way it was going first. That was for going second in the mirror. Lava Golem also for going second in the mirror. Didn't go second in the mirror very much and know that I was going second in the mirror. I mean, so these cards actually just didn't get used very often.
Ryan Fletcher. Oh my God.
For me, Ash, this is what I would just default to.
Best card versus Rogue.
Best card versus Rogue. This is like the default side in when we had no idea what our opponent was playing, because we figured like it's good against every deck. It's not great against anything, but it's like it's good against every deck. So this is usually what I was siding in, and then going second to versus pretty much everything but the mirror. If I knew I was playing the mirror, I wouldn't side this in, but other than that, I would. And three evenly, never sided a once all tournament.
It's expensive.
I just never needed it. Didn't want to side it for the mirror either because they had too many negations. And the last three were three Twin Twisters. Also, don't think I sided the entire turn.
And just for the people that don't understand the FTK, do you want to just show them like a really quick thing? Because it's actually kind of confusing for people that don't understand.
So don't.
Yeah,
I've still seen it once and I still don't know how my
show them. Show them their doom.
Show them this FTK. So like a 2-3 card comp, whatever it is.
You open like Shrine,
this
for example.
Is literally like the
chronograph,
most
chronograph.
Yeah, like that could probably get it all going, right?
Yeah.
Like, Shrine
that, that's how you did it against
like any monster.
Yeah,
and
any monster
there.
At that point. Yeah.
And then like any two like cards that'll get you to dark pendulum.
Yeah,
monsters.
Yeah, and then just like a handful of dark pendulum monsters. So you just Shrine.
Yeah.
You send Dark Worm to the graveyard.
Yeah.
Your special Dark Worm. And use its effect to get zero scale.
The minute left. We're going to once again try to get through this. Alexander Nicholas Carl.
Scale. The chronograph.
Marcus
Monroe. Its effect. Special out. This
Daniel Luis Rivera. We have checked in.
Special out your time gazer.
Ryan John Colina.
Can use Ashcraft's effect. Switch another chronograph.
Daniel Joseph Nowak was checked in. Hendrik Wilhelm Vandermenter.
And then you go into Electrum.
Yep.
Ryan.
And then with Electrum, you send the 13 scale. And this is where my opponents start just being really confused.
Yeah, I didn't know what was happening when you sent the donut.
Send the 13 scale like, to the
donut.
It's a donut. I didn't know what was happening.
It's breast cancer awareness.
Yeah, cancer awareness, you're right. I like it.
And then what you want to do is you want to...
This one's the donut.
Yeah, that's the donut.
Well, probably...
So this is your extra deck. We should party swap.
Yeah.
There we go. That looks right.
Yeah, there we go.
This is so different.
No, you're upside down. You shouldn't know how to do it upside down. This is confusing.
Yeah. And usually you just need like another Dark Pencil monster.
Yeah, just any.
So then you can just summon out like, just scale these, summon out this, and you have to leave another zone open.
Yeah.
To be able to resolve its effect.
So you normally don't pendulum them out back a dark room. Just like
yeah, you don't pendulum them out the dark room because you need it in your extra deck
yeah.
to be able to use this effect.
True.
Right? So you can pendulum them out this and just like any other monster from your hand.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Right? And then you can use Electrum effect to another dark monster
yeah.
on the field if you want.
And you get a free card.
Like you can pop this, get another one. But basically you use its effect to pop your high scale.
Yeah.
Go to the extra deck, summon out Dark Worm from the extra deck.
Yeah.
And then its effect when it's its effect when it's destroyed puts itself in the scale.
Yeah.
So then you just put it in the scale. Yeah, when it's destroyed the monster then it goes in the scale. So
yeah.
Then you use the zero scales effect. When you have the 13 scale also, you can blow them up.
This is where it got wild.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, this is where I was like, I don't know what's happening.
Search is a fusion.
This is so broken.
Oh my god.
And
you're drawing a card.
Yeah, and
then
you're drawing
a free card.
Card
yeah. It doesn't even matter.
And then you take the two things that are in the zones that your link boss points to. Just
so this is under there.
Yeah.
You summon one of your starving venoms.
This is where it gets bad for your opponent.
You use infusion out.
This is where they lose.
Lyrilisk. You can use this effect to burn
that
for 500.
You always
500
burn
yeah.
for
so
5.
So that you can bait ogre because it's unaffected. So if they ogre you, you just,
good
like,
job, kid.
Great job.
And then you just link these away for Zephra. You just make the second Supreme King.
You make the second Supreme King. So wild.
And use their effects to copy.
So copy for 4K.
And because its level is 8 and it burns for 500 times its level, each one burns for 4,000.
And that's usually the extra damage.
You're going second, you do the same thing going second with one of them, and you just burn for 4,000, and then swing for 6,800 attack, piercing damage unaffected by
cards. This is all without attacking it. Yeah. Like, if you went second, like, you'd
like,
just be
like over a trick clown for a game.
Oh, no!
You're right. I was like, I shouldn't do it, but I have to do it. I'm dead.
Yep.
All right, man. Any shouts you want
to
give?
Shout out to my locals, Top Caliber Gaming. Shout out to Noah. It was the FTK was his original idea.
The originator,
evil genius.
This is easily the most unfair deck I've just ever seen like in the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Because it's an FTK deck that can do it every time and is broken every second.
Yeah, it's
so it was wild. Shout out to Mitch.
Goo Martin.
Shout out to Russell. Shout out to Tony, Amelia, Vic, everybody back in Arizona. And that's about it.
All right, man. Congrats on top 16, and thanks for the deck profile,
man.
Thank
you for the deck profile.